Morning to all my dear students. I am Neelam Miss from Mathi English School, your social science teacher, welcoming you all with e-learning educations. And today we are going to continue with our social science lesson number 7, preservation of our heritage, part 2. Before starting our lesson, a good thought for you all. Never say I can't. Always say I will try. Once again, never say I can't. Always say I will try. Before starting our new topic, we will revise what we have learned in last lecture. We have learned a preservation of our heritage. India has a unique place in the world. It has been a remarkable contribution in the field of knowledge, science, religion, culture, art, and architecture. Our heritage shows the dignity of our Asian India. That's why we should committed towards preservation and conservation of our heritage, which is almost a demand of a present time. We have learned about need for the preservation of culture heritage. The heritage of India is multifarious, which brings glory to our nation. Natural and man-made factors are adversely affecting the heritage. Hence, the preservation is required. Necessity for the preservation of culture heritage. Our heritage is the identity of our nation. Hence, heritage act as guide to decide the direction of a development. So, it is necessary to bring awareness to the people regarding the damage done in the places of culture and natural heritage. We have learned about tourism industries and our heritage. Various sites of natural and cultural heritage of India has been accommodated in the list of the World Heritage by UNESCO. This gives boost to our tourism and transportation industry. Apart from also a local people also get employment over there. Now we are going to learn about preservation of heritage and measure to conserve it. It means how we will preserve our heritage. How we will preserve our heritage and conserve it. Preservation means to protect, to take care. Conserve, it means to maintain, to take care. The efforts made of the preservation and conservation of heritage are given below. Indian government has constituted the Indian Board of Wildlife in year 1952 to protect our wildlife. It facilitates with a material for the conservation of a wildlife. It suggests the government for the development of national park, bird sanctuary, geological gardens, along with the task of creating awareness for the protection of wildlife. It means that in year 1952, the Indian government in our constitution, it has been written that there will be a department, the department called Indian Board of Wildlife. This department is going to take care of the protection of wildlife. They will suggest a government that how to conserve the wildlife, how to develop the national parks, bird sanctuary and geological garden. It means in our constitution book, the Wildlife Protection Act has been written in year 1952. There has been a department was made. The name of the department was Indian Board of Wildlife. What are the duty of Indian Board of Wildlife? The duty of Indian Board of Wildlife to protect our wildlife, to provide a facility and conservation to wildlife. And this Indian Board of Wildlife department will give suggestion to our government to develop national parks, bird sanctuaries and geological gardens. And they will even take a task for a creating awareness to protect our wildlife. It means that in our constitution book, it's written that from year 1952 that it is our duty to protect the wildlife. Now the next point is that Wildlife Protection Act, an act in 1972, gave a firm status to national parks, sanctuary and bioreserve. It means that Wildlife Protection Act, once again in our constitution book, the amendment has been made. Amendment matlab to add something. The amendment has made in year 1972 with the firm status. Like now, the national parks, sanctuary and bioreserves will take care more of wildlife. The amendment in the constitution book has been made in year 1972. The national parks, wildlife, sanctuary and bioreserves has been established. National parks is a place that you have learned in lesson number 9. National park is a place where the animals are protected, wildlife sanctuaries where the animals are protected, and bioreserve also a place where the animals are protected. But difference is that in sanctuaries, human movements are allowed. In national parks and bioreserves, human movements are not allowed. National parks, wildlife sanctuaries, bioreserves are established for the protection of wildlife. The laws of our country for the preservation of our heritage have a wide perspective. It means that our constitution, in our constitution books, there are many laws has been written from year 1952, and that laws are very wide and very perspective, that it is our moral duty to protect a wild animal. The strict laws has been formed to stop, the strict laws has been framed to stop the destruction of vanishing vegetation and a wildlife. In our constitution book, it has been written over there that the destruction and vanishing of vegetation and wildlife, it's an a crime. But then also the peoples are not having awareness. They are not taking the care of vegetations and wildlife. Apart from government, there are several societies and organizations which have been actively taking up a task to protection of a wildlife and environment. Not only government, but even there are societies, the NGOs department, the non-governmental societies are also working for the protection of a wildlife. Government has written a laws, norms and rules and regulation in constitution book. The first rules was written in year 1952 to protect a Wildlife Protection Act, and once again the amendment has been made in year 1972. So government is taking a care of wildlife, but with the government there are other several societies and organizations are also actively taking a part in the protection of wildlife. Bombay Natural History Society is the oldest one of its kind, was established in year 1883. It means that the Bombay Natural History Society was the organization, was the oldest organization, was established in year 1883. It is also working for the protection of a wildlife. Presently, Agir Foundation, Natural Club, etc., the institution are doing a noble work for the environmental preservation. Like a Bombay Natural History Society and Gir Foundation, even Natural Club, etc., this all are the institute. They are giving their contribution. They are doing a noble work for the environmental preservation. Realizing the importance of a preservation of our heritage, constitution frames made it mandatory that it should be included in our constitution. It means that a framers, the one who have the leaders and the scholars, those who have written our constitution, the peoples, those who are adding laws in a constitution, the framers, we call them framers, have a mandatory, you know, that included in our constitution that it is important to preserve our heritage. Even it is written in our constitution book, so we have to follow that rules and regulation to conserve our heritage. Now we will learn about ancient memorial and archaeological sites and remaining act. This act has been written in constitution to protect the monuments, to protect a ancient memorial, a heritage which is made by our ancestors. There are, you know, that the archaeological site means there is archaeology. Archaeology means the study of ancient culture through examination of their buildings, tools and other objects. It means that they will research, that they will examine that culture, that building, that tools, that object at that time when this building has been made, what the material has been used, how it is made. There the archaeological department to do this type of work. An archaeological site. Now what is meant by archaeological site? Archaeological site means is a place in which the evidence of past activity is preserved and which has been over maybe investigate using the discipline and manner. It means that archaeological site is mean that you will get a past evidence of something has been held over there and the archaeological department peoples will investigates over there to found out something. Now we will learn about this act. There are more dangerous and harmful factor arose in a way of heritage that we are knowing that dangerous and harmful factors like natural calamities and even a man-made negligence, the monuments are getting degraded. The more strict actions and effort were made time to time for the preservation, but now government are taking a strict actions and putting their effort time to time for the preservation. It means that government is taking a lots of tricks, rules and regulation to preserve our heritage, that a people, a local people should not damage it. Hence various protective measures have been taken for the safeguard of heritage. It means they are the government putting the maximum efforts, putting the maximum measures to take a care and take a safeguard of our heritage, because after all it is the identity of our country. The ancient monuments and archaeological sites and remaining act was enacted in year 1958. It means in our constitution book, the ancient memorial and archaeological site remaining act has been written in our constitution in year 1958. This act was written in our constitution book. This act suggests for the preservation of antique artistic work, religious places, historical memorials and archaeological site. It means that if this department has been made in year 1958, now what work this department is going to do? This department is going to preserve the antique, it means a unique artistic work. They will the religious places, historical memorials and archaeological site. This is the duty of that people, that they will preserve, they will protect and take care of this unique artistic places, religious places, historical monuments and even the antique work which is done by our ancestors. These are the duties of Asian monument and archaeological site department. They will do like a wildlife, Indian Wildlife Protection Board. They will protect the wildlife. They will suggest a government to protect, how to protect a wildlife like this way. This is the another department. This department is also take care for the preservation of our heritage. That department will take care of the Indian Board of Wildlife, will take care of wild animals. Even this department, the Asian Monuments, Archaeological Sites and Remaining Act, the department will take care of monuments and how to preserve monuments. This Archaeological Act ensures that no person or agency can conduct archaeological excavation without the prior permission of a government. This archaeological, it means that this department will ensure to the people or the agency that without the archaeological, you can't do excavation. Excavation, it means do a digging in the land to find some precious material. Without the government permission, you can't excavate anywhere. Only archaeological department is having a prior permission from a government to excavate any place. It means that we the people, if we want to excavate anywhere, we can't excavate because we have to take a permission. It is the permission is only archaeological department is having a permission to excavate, and without a prior permission of government, if you are doing excavation at any place, then it is an illegal offense. This action is consequently stopped. This action has consequently stopped clandestine excavation. Hence, many of our heritage sites are still preserved and kept intact. Now, the question is coming in your mind, what is clandestine? Clandestine, it means that planned or done in a secret, the excavation, to do a excavation in a secret, especially describing something that is officially not allowed. It means that to the one who do excavation without the permission of a government, it means clandestine excavation. If we are doing excavation to find out any precious thing that in the ground, then without the permission, if we are doing this excavation in the secret form, then it is known as clandestine excavation. So because of this archaeological excavation, and we have to take a prior permission from a government, hence many of our heritage sites are still preserved and kept enacted. Otherwise, you know that everyone is going to excavate anywhere to find out the precious thing. But because of this norms, rules and regulation which is written in our constitution, so our heritage is preserved right now. The government of India declared some historical places as national monuments. Department of Archaeological is responsible to look after the preservation of these monuments. It means that there are the historical places in India. It gives a boost to tourism industry like a Taj Mahal, Qutub Minar, Buland Darwaza. These all are the national monuments. So the government has given this work to the Department of Archaeology. It means that a Department of Archaeology is responsible to look after this monument, to take care of these monuments. The government has given a work to this department, this special department, and this special department will take care of this national monument. However, these heritage sites will not be preserved just by framing laws. It means that if we want to preserve our heritage, then if we have written a one line in constitution book, then our heritage is not going to preserve to just a frame a one law in a book. But it becomes a moral responsibility of every citizen. See, government has done their work. They have written in a constitution also that it is our moral duty to protect our heritage. But as a citizen of India, it is we have to take responsibility to preserve our monuments. Department of Archaeology maintain the sites of heritage which is either destroyed or on verge of a destruction. Even it means that archaeological department will maintain that site. They will look after that monuments even it is if it is either destroyed or they are verge to destroy. Destroyed it means the monument which is totally destroyed, then archaeological department will work on that monuments and will bring it to will bring it to its original form. Either if it is destroyed, then amenity verge to destruction, it means that the 50% of monument has been degraded and 50% it's, you know, it is in original form. It means 50% is okay. So the archaeological department will take care of a destroy or verge to destroy. Both the monuments they will take care. While taking up a work of maintenance of a monument, one should keep in the mind that they should be preserved in such a manner so that it retain its original shape, size and condition intact. It means that if archaeological site is, you know, that working on the monument, taking care of that monument which is destroyed or which is verge of destruction, at that time they should keep one thing in their mind, that when they are preserving or maintaining that monument, at the original, it should be in original shape and size. It means that if you know that they are working, if their preservation is going on Qutub Minar, for example, the Qutub Minar, so they will take care at the time of a cleanliness of Qutub Minar or at the time of a renovation, they should keep a one thing in a mind that the original shape, color and size should not be changed. They have to first work on it that original shape could not be changed, original color should not be changed and original size should not be changed. That in this manner they have to preserve heritage and in this manner they have to do work on it. The Department of Archaeological Survey of India means ASI. ASI stand for Archaeological Survey of India. It means that this department is having a work of 5,000 and more monuments. The ASI has more than 5,000 monuments and sites under their protection. It means ASI is working on 5,000 monuments and sites of India are there in under their protection. Sangmeshwar Temple and Papnasham Temple in Andhra Pradesh were going to be submerged into the sea due to the construction of Naga Arjun Sagar multi-purpose project. Therefore, this temple has been successfully shifted to Alampur at Mehboob Nagar district of Andhra Pradesh. It means that this two temple, that is Sangmeshwar Temple and Papnasham Temple, was in Andhra Pradesh. But because of the construction of Naga Arjun Sagar multi-purpose project, this both of the temples are going to submerge into the sea. Now, the archaeological department like ASI has think that to shift this temple to Alampur at Mehboob Nagar district of Andhra Pradesh. Now, the question is coming in your mind that how could it possible to shift the temple from one district to another district? Yes, my dear children, it is possible with the help of modern technology and the innovation in the innovation in modern technology. This is possible the temples can be relocated using modern technology with the help of fixing jack screws. It means because of the help of jack and screws, we can shift one monument from one place to another place without a destruction or without the damage. I'll show you the picture, so at that time you can easily understand that how could it possible to relocate one temple from one place to another place. Taj Mahal of Agra is one of the seven wonders of the world that we all are knowing, that Taj is a seven wonders of the world. So it how important for us, because Taj is on precious monuments in India, coming in seven wonders of the world. So it is how our government is, you know, that taking a care of that monument. Even ASI is also taking a care of that monument. But so now we will learn that how Taj is also getting a degraded and what action ASI has taken. Air pollution caused by Mathura oil refinery and fast growing nearby industry. Fast growing industries turn the white marble pale and dull. It means that the industry, the Mathura oil refinery industry, was nearby a Taj Mahal, and because of that oil refinery industry, the smoke was coming out, and because of that air pollution, the white marble of Taj is getting pale and dull. Pale, it means a yellowish. It's getting yellowish and it's getting dull because of that air pollution, the smokes which is coming by Mathura oil refinery industry. So the Department of Archaeology took a suitable step to close the industry spreading the air pollution in its neighborhood. So the ASI has taken a task to close that industry only because it was creating air pollution, and because of the air pollution, the precious monument, our Taj Mahal, which is a seven wonders of the world, it's getting a pale and dull. So it is better that the ASI took this task to stop that industry, to close that industry only, so that we can maintain and preserve the Taj Mahal. Regular cleaning of the structure has brought back the brightness of Taj Mahal. Like a regular cleaning and structure, and because of the archaeological department are working too hard for the cleanliness, for the renovations, for the shape, for the original size. They took a little, you know, that little care of the monument. So because of that, once again, the brightness of a Taj has been came back. So today we have learned about preservation of heritage and measure to conserve it. To preserve a wildlife, the Indian government has written in the Constitution book, the Indian Board of Wildlife Protection Act in year 1952. Indian Board of Wildlife is a department is taking a care of wildlife, not, and this act is one again has been done amendment in year 1972 with the firm status that it came with a national park, sanctuaries and bio reserve for the protection of a wildlife. Not only the government but even other societies and organization are also actively working for the protection of wildlife. One of the example is Bombay Natural History Society was established in 1833. Gir Foundation, Natural Club, etc. are doing a noble work for the preservation. Even like a wildlife protection, government has also written in a constitution that act for to preserve our monument. The act was ancient Memorial and Archaeological Site and Remaining Act. This act was written in 1958 in our Constitution book. The aim to make this act is that we can able to preserve our artistic work, religious places, historical memorials and archaeological site. Which department is working on this? The ASI department, that is Department of Archaeological Survey of India. What is the work of this department? This department will take care of national monument and preserve this monument. If that the department is going to take care of the monument or heritage which is destroyed or on the verge of destruction, even they are taking care of 5,000 monuments and other sites under their protection. In next lecture, we will continue with this lesson with a new topic. Till then, thank you.